Hi students, welcome back to this video. Listen to this inspirational card. There are no limits to what you can accomplish except the limits you place on your own thinking. We have to finish up two more topics of the same lesson. That is, first one, transgenic animals, and the other one is ethical issues. So we can begin with transgenic animals. Yes, transgenic animals are otherwise known as GM animals. What do you mean by GM animals? Genetically modified animals. So what are genetically modified animals? These are the animals whose genome has been altered by introduction of a foreign gene by manipulation. Genome has been altered by introduction of an extra gene by manipulation. Then various examples are there: transgenic rats, rabbits, pigs, sheep, cow and fish. Over 95% of the transgenic animals are mice. What are the benefits of this transgenic animals? From your examination point of view, we can expect 2 marks question from this area. Benefits or advantages of transgenic animals. To study the regulation of genes on normal physiology and development. To study the contribution of genes in the development of a disease. Third one is biological products. Fourth one, vaccine safety testing. And fifth one is chemical safety testing. That is toxicity testing. For all these purposes, transgenic animals are used. So let us see one by one. To study regulation of genes on normal physiology and development. Example, study of complex factors such as insulin-like growth factors. Genes from other species that alter formation of this factor are introduced and the biological effects are studied. This gives information about the biological role of the factor in the body. Second one is to study the contribution of genes in the development of a disease. Transgenic models help to investigate new treatments for human diseases. Example, transgenic models for many human diseases like cancer, cystic fibrosis, rheumatoid arthritis and Alzheimer's. Yes, biological products is the third one. Transgenic animals are used to produce biological products by introducing genes which codes for a particular product. Example, human protein like alpha-1 antitrypsin is used to treat emphysema. Products for treatment of phenylketonuria, PKU, and the other diseases, cystic fibrosis. Then there is a cow, there is a first transgenic cow named Rosie, produced human protein enriched milk. Quantity is 2.4 gram per liter. Yes, that is introduced in the year 1997. It contains human alpha lactalbumin. It is nutritionally more balanced product for human babies than natural cow milk. Then next one is vaccine safety testing. Transgenic mice are used to test the safety of the polio vaccine. If it is reliable, they can replace the use of monkeys to test the safety of the vaccine. Last one is toxicity testing. Whatever the toxins are there. In order to test their toxicity, we can use the transgenic animals. Safety testing. Actually, this is a safety test. Some transgenic animals carry genes which make them more sensitive to toxic substances than non-transgenic animals. They are exposed to the toxic substances and the effects studied. It gives immediate result. So, what do you mean by transgenic animals and what are the benefits of transgenic animals that we went through? And the last area of this lesson is ethical issues. Yes, the product of biotechnology gives us unpredicted result. So this is the main area, problems of unpredicted result, so that we have to get the permission. Genetic modification may cause unpredictable result when such organisms are introduced into ecosystem that we cannot say what result it is going to be given. So Indian government has set up organizations like GEAC, that is Genetic Engineering Approval Committee, that make decisions about the validity of GM research, genetically modified animals research, and the safety of GM organisms of public services. It is the use of bioresources, that is biopiracy. What do you mean by biopiracy? Biopiracy is the use of bioresources by multinational companies and other organizations without proper authorization from the countries and people concerned. You know, certain companies got patents for products and technologies that make use of the genetic materials, plants, etc., that have been identified, developed and used by farmers and indigenous people of a country. Example, basmati rice, herbal medicines like turmeric, neem, etc. Basmati rice has unique aroma and flavor. India has 27 varieties of basmati. Here in this photo you can see patented. In 1997, an American company got patent right on basmati rice through the US Patent and Trademark Office. This allowed the company to sell a new variety of basmati. This was actually derived from Indian farmers' varieties. Indian basmati was crossed with the semi-dwarf varieties and claimed as a novelty. Other people selling basmati rice could be restricted by patent. Most of the industrialized nations are poor in biodiversity and traditional knowledge. The developing and the underdeveloped world have rich biodiversity and traditional knowledge related to bioresources. It has to develop laws to prevent unauthorized exploitation of bioresources and traditional knowledge. Indian Parliament has cleared the Second Amendment of the Indian Patent Bill that takes such issues into consideration, including patent terms, emergency provisions, and research and development initiative. Okay, students, that's all about today's topic. Thank you for watching this.